Hello and welcome. I'm Professor Tsuchiya, and I'll be guiding you through this introductory course on using Simulink to simulate dynamic systems. MATLAB and Simulink are part of an industry-standard software package used by engineers everywhere, including industries like automotive, aerospace, robotics, and control systems, to name a few. Being proficient in Simulink will make you much more desirable to prospective employers and a stronger engineer overall. Before you proceed, you should make sure that you have enough prerequisite knowledge for this course to be worthwhile. You should have a working knowledge of the MATLAB programming language, and you should also have a general idea of how to analyze the behavior of dynamic systems. Regarding hardware and software, you should have a computer with MATLAB and Simulink installed. Any recent release is okay, but I'll be using MATLAB 2016A throughout this series. If you have MATLAB, but you are unsure of whether or not you have Simulink, you can type the letters VER for version in the command window of MATLAB to see what add-ons you have installed. One of the primary uses for Simulink is to analyze the behavior of dynamic systems under the influence of different real-world scenarios. It allows the engineer to run simulations of a particular system under user-specified forcing functions and initial conditions. Being able to accurately simulate the response of a dynamic system is a crucial part of any engineering design process because it allows the engineer to quickly make design improvements and to catch any potential design flaws early on. By the end of this course, you'll be able to build a Simulink model representing a real dynamic system, simulate that model under user-defined inputs and initial conditions, adjust the parameters of simulation, and analyze the simulated outputs. One of the first things to understand is that Simulink can't magically produce a system model for you. In other words, it's up to you as the engineer to program the system dynamics into Simulink first. Only then can the power of Simulink truly be realized. So, before we actually dive into the inner workings of the Simulink program, we'll need to do a quick review of what it means to model a dynamic system, which we'll discuss in the next video.